like a good cover, this panel is also full of surprises. Some of the panelists are surprised. But I have to say that it's been a huge privilege to be associated with this prize over the last 5 years. I've watched the quality of the entries change. I've watched the designers getting acknowledgement. The panel today is a very special panel. Two of them are winners from the past. Devangana is a designer as well. And she's also, she writes and she designs. Arsen is a bookstore in himself. He has the inspirational bookstore in the Boulder Pearl Mall. It's a bookstore I'm in love with. And he understands covers because his bookstore is full of all sorts of accessories to writing. I remember those t-shirts there, always searching for the XL with the sort of logo about books. And Shobhaa, I am going to make the cliche of saying that she has needs no introduction, but she has been a very perceptive jury member. And her photography, for those of you who don't realize that she is an absolutely brilliant photographer. And I know that her book of author portraits will be out soon. Though she, it's in your head still, but it will be there. So I'd like Kunal.
I said if there's a publisher out there, I'll happy to do a deal right after the session.
I'm going.
So far, there have just been portraits by day that I've enjoyed very much taking.
Kunal and Aanchal have both been previous winners of this prize. And I remember when each of them got their announcement for the prize, they had a lot to say. Kunal had this brilliant presentation of the different stages of the cover prize, what he had rejected, what he had kept. And Aanchal's photograph, of that iconic photograph, it's moved so many people emotionally so much. So I'd just to keep it short and uncomplicated, maybe we begin either this direction or that on what a cover prize means to you personally in terms of the work you have done and also in a more general way in terms of the books you appreciated. As an author, as a designer, as a bookseller, it's anybody's vote whether we begin right or left, left or right. These days the right is in power but the left is challenging them. Right or left?
Well, I'm very troubled starting from the right because I'm from the left.
I'm keeping my mouth shut.
Well, he's not a leftist.
Well, I'm a bookseller, and one of the major things in our bookstore is when you come into the store, you have several cases of recommended titles. And all these titles, six cases, they're all faced out with a recommendation. So you can see the beautiful array of colors, covers from different publishers. And, you know, I think the key for a cover is it needs to be striking, it needs to be beautiful, it needs to tell you something about the book right away. But a great cover will also matches the book inside. You know, it can't just be a beautiful image, but it has to convey what kind of book it is. And all that, to design that, is quite an amazing feat, I think. And I do think that in the last 10 to 15 years, in America at least, it's harder for me to speak about India, but I know in America in the last 10 or 15 years, book cover design has gotten much better. I think that the threat of e-books, publishers were quite worried that bookstores might go away, that they needed to have extra value in the books, and they've made them more beautiful. And I think we're seeing that across all genres. And I've been in many stores here in India, so I think it's true here. Some of the covers are the same as our American covers, and some of the covers are quite different for the same books. And I find that interesting because I think there must be a cultural difference, obviously, of what people in India want as opposed to what people in America want in a cover, what people in England want in a cover. But they're quite beautiful and striking. And so, you know, it's interesting to be here in this panel and to see this cover here, beautiful color and flowers, and it strikes, tells me right away what that book is going to be. So we actually have a restaurant in Boulder, Colorado called Tiffin. So there you go. All right, I'm going to pass it on now. Well, books will sell better if they're faced out. And so if you're an author or a publisher here and you ever walk into a bookstore, the best thing you can do is kind of, you know, go in there and face all your books out so the covers show. I actually think an important aspect of book cover design that doesn't get talked about as much but is actually critical is that the spine looks good. Because most books are spined out. And if you don't have the spine right... And I've been very curious, and maybe people can talk about this, in a couple of the bookstores in India, I saw something I've never seen in America, where the books are stacked up, spined out horizontally. And in America, we always stack them up vertically, but you can obviously read them better horizontally. And so I thought that was interesting, and that's one of the notes that I'm taking back to America, and my staff will think I am absolutely nuts. But I took a lot of photos to show that it can work.
When you do your beautiful displays, it's almost like a mosaic. Do you color coordinate them?
Sometimes we do. We color coordinate. Sometimes we do a window. So we're on a walking mall, which we get many, many pedestrians every single day. And so sometimes the windows will be an all red window, or all a green window, or all a white window. And people really stop and look at those windows. And then they come in and they say, because they haven't even registered why they stopped, and they'll say, there's a book in the window, it's red. I'm like, every book in the window is red. It's the red window. But they usually, they'll say that anyway.
You know, I think it's the first seduction, the cover. Before you even know what the book is about, if it draws you in and it is powerful enough to engage you visually and make you curious, that's the first very big step forward towards actually buying the book. The content, of course, is king. But for many years, as someone in publishing, the importance of... designing an appropriate jacket was completely not that given the kind of emphasis it deserves. And they were almost turned out mechanically, and there used to be a certain trend. One year, all the book covers looked almost identical. Then it came to a point where all of them had a commercial angle to it, so they were called commercial covers that jump out at you from a bookshelf and make you want to buy the book. And they all looked like American covers. There was nothing Indian about it. And having been published in different countries, whenever a book of mine was to be published elsewhere, they would look for elephants or a lady with a bindi or something exotic or a veiled person. There'd be peacocks or sometimes all of it. So make no mistake, this book is from India, right? Get it? So that has, I think that has shifted. And the books today speak, the jackets speak a language which is quite their own. It's an independent language, which is graphic and which is attractive and powerful. And the designers are getting their due. All these years, nobody knew who designed a book cover. It was the author and the publisher's name, and that was about it. And some of the authors who had at least the courtesy of acknowledging it in their acknowledgments, but otherwise the designers really did get a raw deal. So it's wonderful to see talent being acknowledged, because it really is the first step towards buying the book.
I want to ask Kunal now. Let's go left, right, right, left. So that in the center, Ms. Aanchal will end with the remnants of a budget.
This doesn't seem to work.
Thank you. Namita, I'm a failed artist. So I'm fiendish when it comes to covers.
Well, But how do you say you're a failed artist? Did you study art? Or?
No, I wanted to be an artist, but I got distracted and became an academic, you know, which was a big mistake. I drive publishers up the wall. The reason is, I don't like descriptive jackets. I like jackets that are metaphorical, that, as you said, convey and bring out what this book is about, which of course means that the designer needs to have read the book. I was incredibly fortunate in my Indian editions, having Pinaki De, who's one of the winners, I didn't win the award, he did, for a novel which I wrote called Calcutta. So I'm going to say just a few words about that to say, to describe the process. So Pinaki read Calcutta. It's a novel about a male prostitute, a gigolo, in Kolkata. Okay. And having read the novel, we engaged in long conversations. I was in Oxford, he was in Chandanagar in Bengal. Despite the time difference, we talked for hours about the book. He came up with 7 variations of the cover, and I rejected all of them. I didn't want the Howrah Bridge on the cover, nothing descriptive. Didn't want a tram on the cover. Okay. Didn't want it to look like Kolkata. I wanted to bring out the essence of this man. That's the cover. So the dog man. And so one night, late at night, his side, he said, well, what is this novel really about? This novel is really about us being afraid of our fellow citizens. The poor are afraid of the rich are afraid of the poor. Okay? Just like we, if you walk by the street at night and you see a street dog, you're afraid. The street dog might bite you. But the dog is afraid of you, that you might throw a stone at it. So he came up with this notion of the dog man. It was metaphorical, which was powerful, which was eye-catching, and of course won the Oxford Award. So I think it's, for me, a book is also an artifact. Long after somebody has read the book, it will sit on somebody's desk or in a bookshelf. It'll pass from hand to hand. And therefore, it needs to be as attractive, as enticing as any other good artifact. So that's why the book cover is incredibly important to me.
Thank you. You got that through very well. What about you, Maria? Can you give the background of what you do and how? What drives you to cover, not only cover design, but to design of the book altogether?
Right. Yes, I work as a book designer. And of course, one of the cliched questions everybody must have asked, you guys also, do you judge a book by its cover? And I am a book designer. I literally earn my roti kapda from there. So I think we should already trash that conversation because I don't think you should be judging a book by the cover, but you should definitely judge the cover.
But didn't you also write the book with the cover?
Yeah, sorry?
You've also written.
Yeah, I'm talking as a book designer.
So we'll talk about both.
Okay, I will.
Because that's a very different thing you do.
Yeah, I'll talk about that too. So yeah, I think all I'm saying is that it's important to analyze the covers you see. And so many, like he said, that how it becomes an artifact, it's definitely like a different attire when books go into reprints for years and years, and so many books carry different jackets, and I have been a snob like that. If I like a cover, I'd want that particular edition, even if it is published in New Zealand. I'd pay more on Amazon and get that, but not many people do that, but actually because the cover brings that character out in one story. And like Namita said, I also wrote a book. Some of the covers that I worked on are getting displayed here. So you see a category, how your covers also change. If it's a nonfiction, it's, you know, this is all nonfiction where your title is, most of them has a central element. This is an illustrated cover I did recently for Bhagavad Gita's classic edition. So this was something minimal, beautiful book, heart. So it's so important. And that's, the last one is The Jungle Radio. I just completed my session for this book right now on children's literature. I've illustrated, designed, and written this picture book. So again, that it's so important because here I've curated this with a lot of difficulty because I wanted categories that you have to see your target audience because a children's book, you know how there's some, a bookseller will know this, that we are always given as designers some of the mantras that, it should definitely be a bright cover, it's for children. And it sometimes makes me angry that no, it's not important. A white cover can totally work for a kid. It's about the positioning right. And but yeah, so that's how it becomes
because
important.
Because I know that the Jungle Radio, which you wrote and which you illustrated, it was one of my favorites for this prize as well.
Yeah.
And my granddaughter loved it because she could immediately relate to the different pictures.
Yeah.
So I think that's a rare talent which you must develop. And yeah. Of writing and designing together, do you feel it's a different sort of a outcome when you're writing and designing and a different outcome when you're designing from the outside?
Oh, definitely, because I do both. I work with authors, take their brief, and also...
So do you give yourself a brief or it flows naturally?
Yeah, so that's a
when
great
when you work
question.
On your own book.
Oh, for my own book. Okay. Yeah, so that is a challenge which anybody will face because you're too attached to your book then. And I remember my colleagues were really making fun of me because I was designing the book, writing the book and illustrating it. And they were like, can you please get rid of it? Because I was just not letting go of it because I was really attached. And I actually called my colleagues and I said, can you please go through this book now? I want to close the file on my system. Because, yeah, so that's difficult. But when you're working for an author, so the basic process for those of you who don't know, because editors commission the book, sometimes editors are in conversation with their respective authors. So they are in touch with the authors. They want what is the story you want on the cover. In fiction books, the designer mostly, I as a designer mostly end up reading my whole book because in fiction, any scene can really hit you and you want that on the cover. Whereas nonfiction, you really know what is the book on. So I know many designers will have a different process, but that's how I've worked so far. So for the Jungle Radio, because it's a picture book works on brevity. It's less is more, very little text. Pictures do most of your talking and... And it's for a very young age group, so even a four-year-old can relate to it, look at the picture because the size of the book is... So yeah, size is another component which helps the designer because how the book is packaged. The typography is big on every page. There are bird sounds in the book, so you can keep your finger... a child can keep the finger on the sound and identify all the birds in the book. So that is how a design process works on. But yeah, cover briefs are... refer to them like a Bible because we work on so many covers at once that it's difficult to multitask. So I'm working on a health book at the same time I'm working on something on crime or something on Indian politics. So the cover brief is basically that is my
go-to.
So
in fact, one of the conversations we had or are having around the prize is that we need a separate category for young readers, genre. Children. Because it's a different language and a different graphics that needs to reach out, and it's a more total design. And I know everybody here is very tired, you've all had a long day, you've all taken in a lot of ideas and thoughts, and so our last lady for the evening is going to tell us about her wonderful cover, which remained imprinted in the minds of the audience. I don't know if we have the cover showing up somewhere.
Can we bring it up?
With Neeta, can we show the cover, please, of Remnants of Herself?
That's really
yes.
Okay.
The audience will understand. Tell us about the background of this image.
So I actually am trained as an artist. My entire education has been as a metal engraver. So I come to literature, come to writing from the fine arts. So it's very important for me to know the project that I'm working on has emerged from the visual. For those of you who don't know about this book, it is about the artifacts that refugees carried across the border in 1947 when they left their homes at the time of partition, either to India or Pakistan. So really the book was so visceral and tactile because it dealt with objects. The photograph on the cover is of my grandmother, and I remember the day I took it because we were talking about this mang tikka that her mother had carried from Dera Ismail Khan in the Northwest Frontier Province to Delhi in August 47. And I asked her to put the mang tikka on, and it was the second time in her life that she had worn it. Once at her wedding when her mother bequeathed it to her, and once when I asked her. And she put it on. It was like a game. It was like she had become a child. And she put it on, and she said, oh, it's too colorful because her hair is completely white. And she said, it's too colorful for an old woman to wear. She was also awkward because it was heavy. But I think there was such joy. And I think in this photograph, it is the eyes that are most striking because I think even as a child, I loved all the little wrinkles that old people have. It's such a strange thing to love, but I love the little wrinkles around her eyes. And she hates this photograph because when she looks at it, I think it's difficult to see yourself as other people see you, as an older person, as a person who is no longer youthful looking. And so when she looks at the photograph, she's always like, oh, look at these wrinkles. This is so, you know, I look like an old woman. But there is such purity in this image that when I was writing the book, it was always clear from the beginning that this was going to be the cover because it is powerful. It gives a message that the book is about objects. It is about items. It is sensual. It is intimate. I think everything just kind of fit together. There was never a doubt in my mind about what the cover would be because this was the image that had become the kind of touchstone for the project. So I was always very clear.
So one thing about this cover, I think it's because her hair is white that the whole thing works so brilliantly.
Yes, I also think
because the colors stand out.
Yeah, I also think
it is a beautiful...
It was nice and it always... there's kind of like a warm, buttery feeling when I think about it because that afternoon was so much fun and it was just by chance that we took this photograph and she was so youthful, she was so childish.
You know, so all of you in the publishing industry and associated book trade, I mean, it's been fascinating for me as a writer, as a part-time publisher sometimes, to hear all of you on your covers and it really was very, very moving. Each of you had such a different experience and sharing it with all of you. We have time for one question or two questions if anybody wants and then we wind up to any of these people in the audience. Are there any questions? If there are not, we can ask each other any question if there's any and otherwise we can just say one or two last words and then on to a glass of red wine courtesy the Oxford Bookstore. Yeah, please.
So when I talk to authors in America, most of them don't have much say and sometimes no say whatsoever on their cover. And here we're talking to authors that had quite a bit of say. Is that typical in India or is it by writer? Or you know, because it would be fairly unusual. You'd have to be a pretty famous writer with a publisher that actually likes you quite a bit to have that level of influence.
I think one can negotiate that. I think many authors feel too diffident of their publishers. And they say that, we'll go with whatever they know best. They understand the marketplace. We are poor authors, we don't. So I think many publishers, may not be all, would be quite open to a collaboration. Okay. And I think one of the real benefits of a jacket is that there is excitement left after the book has been written. You know, there's great excitement when you're writing the book and as an author, but the excitement doesn't stop once you finish writing the book. So there's an opportunity for collaboration, an artistic collaboration, with the designer, with the publisher, with the commissioning editor, and I think authors should take up on that.
My early books, definitely I agree with Kunal that you're diffident, you don't have the confidence, you're intimidated by your publishers, and you say whatever you think, yes. So my early books were victims of exactly that. I hated the designs, but I had very little say. In those days also, the budget simply weren't there to get the top talent. So in my case, the easiest thing would be to tell me that do you have any movie star friends who don't mind if their pictures are used as a representational thing, and they'll do it for free? So I'd call up, there's Shonali Bendre on one of my books, there's Nina Gupta, there's Kritika, three or four people who I knew well enough to say, hey, you know, we don't have the budgets, but can we use your images? And then I started to assert myself much later in life. And now, I liked your word, I've become a fiend. And till I get the image that I think is appropriate for the book, I will fight for it. I will just not compromise and say, okay, go with whatever you think.
I do think that often publishers do ask authors, because I know having worked in an agency previously, that there is always a conversation, do you have an image in mind? Do you have a color scheme in mind? So I think that what Kunal said about it being collaborative is definitely true, but the opposite on either ends has also been seen, where an author comes with an image and that's it, or the author has no idea and is open to the interpretation. One thing I always think about is that if I didn't have a cover image, what would my cover have been? And I have no idea.
I've actually dropped a publisher because they put on a jacket which they didn't seek my permission. It was a language publisher.
That's dire.
So I absolutely dropped. That was a top language publisher in Bangla. And I said, I'm not going to publish with you.
You dropped your jacket. But you know, I have the very opposite experience from all of you. When you are doing a cover, in your own head, you imagine the writer has already read it. I'd have all kinds of irritating, only this ideas. Ravi used to be my editor, and we would have our little scraps about it. And I learned in the end that often the designers and the publishers know better what will work in the market. One of my books bombed because I insisted, and they had to put up with it. This is the cover I wanted. And I had to eat humble pie because that was the cover I wanted. Nobody else wanted that cover. I mean, nobody means no reader wanted to go and buy it. And I'd go to booksellers, I'd say, Bikri, and they'd say, Madam, cover doesn't work. So it's all ends of it. And thank you all. I had so much fun listening into all of you. I think it's time for us to say thank you to the long day that all of you have put in here at the Jaipur Bookmark. Nita? Yeah. Last words from Nita.
Yeah, I think before I invite all of you to join us for cocktails, I'd like to invite Sneha to say a few words as the winner today.
Of course.
Was a surprise, Sneha, but
well, I'm honored for.
I think I'll just.
So it's an honor to receive this award, and frankly, I was not expecting that I'll be called up. So excuse me if like. You know, whatever comes out of my mouth is, I mean, yeah, relevant, not relevant. But I would say, like, you know, for this cover, it's like you're talking of collaborations and team efforts. It's an illustrated book inside out. So to start with, this was to be a book of regional recipes. So, you know, we started from there, and how we arrived at the title of the book, Tiffin, that it's regional recipes. So, you know, what is the common element? You know, so it was this humble tiffin that's in every household, north, east, south, west. So we came up with tiffin, you know, that would probably encapsulate everything that we were trying to, you know, package in this book. So, and since it was to be an illustrated book, okay, you know, then came the visual elements, and we started working, you know, with illustrators, and so it was like, you know, how do we do? So it was like we picked up all the, you know, elements from textiles and tribal art, and you know, so we represented. So the tiffin kept like changing, you know, it became like an eastern tiffin or a northern tiffin, and so and. To like sum it up on the cover, it was, we just went floral because it was like, you know, summing up the diversity, because inside you have, you know, motifs from Gujarat or like, you know, textile of south, or, I mean, of the east. So, but on the cover, we wanted to go simple yet combine everything together. So, and there are like lots of people, it's just not like one person and the cover is right there. I mean, there's so many people, like two of them, Anisha and Neelam, are right here. And I would like to thank, you know, everybody, like my publishers, Pramod Kapoor, Kapil, Priya, like it's a team effort. So I can't like just, you know. Yeah, so thank you so much for like, you know, selecting this cover. And thank you.